want to show this picture in a reel, you
can very much, especially your active participation.
Hop in the car, watch it go vroom, vroom. I told them all that I was soon, soon. Knew as a child, back in the womb.
Can't wait to see this.
So, dear students, let's start our lesson. Today's lesson is devoted to the museums. Worldwide museums, top-rated museums in the world, and etc. So, as you see, culture and modern society, museums and art galleries, top-rated museums and art galleries. Are you museum goers or non-museum goers? Are you a museum goer?
I go to the museums once in a blue moon. Whenever I find spare time, I go to the museums with my friends so they spend my time in a relaxed way.
Thank you very much. What about others? Sivinch?
I've never been in a museum, but
really?
I want to be. I'm interested in art galleries, especially famous paintings.
Very good. So today, together we will go to the museums. Yes? Presentation here. A museum is a place where one should lose one's head. Do you agree with this? Can we forget about everything and see the history? Yes? And we can lose our head when we are in front of just painting like Mona Lisa or self-portrait of Vincent van Gogh or some flowers like these exhibitions. Yes, you know. New words I'm going to show you. You can see reputation scores top 5 museums, and here 84.3% for the museum. What museum is it?
Lower.
Yes, lower. In Paris, yes,
yeah.
France, Paris, yes, the wonderful, one of the most famous museum, art museum is, yes, located. And what do you know about this museum? What are they in this museum?
Different
kind
of paintings.
Yes, very good. For example,
now I'm gonna talk about the wonder about the sea of foam. So first of all, you should know who is the artist. I should say the artist's name is David Friedrich. He's a famous artist in German. So you can see the wonder about the sea of fog. This painting was painted in 1880, and so it has been considered of the masterpieces.
Mm-hmm.
Masterpieces and Rocky Mountains on a picture.
Uh-huh.
This person had a feeling about, for example, anything is Friedrich, the artist of Friedrich, common user of the Rocken figure. What is a Rocken figure? Rocken figure is a German rear facing Victoria. That's all.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Do you
Thank
have
you.
Any questions?
No,
no,
maybe you can have.
No.
So, where can we see this painting?
Oh.
Where? In what museum I can, yes, find this painting?
If you want to show this picture in a reel, you can go to the Art Galleries Museum. So, congratulations.
Uh-huh. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Arzona, very interesting.
Yeah.
Why the colors are just dark? Who knows?
Maybe the artist of Frederick went to this picture in dark.
And also in this picture, a man is thinking about his problems, any problems. Mm-hmm. That's why the painter chose these kinds of the colors.
Very good. So?
Now I'm gonna talk about a painting which is named a Scream. In German language, it's called Der Schrei der Natur. It's named a Scream of Nature. At first, people may see a scream of skull, the skull-shaped head, but it isn't about it. It's about the scream of nature. Just pay attention to the background of nature. This when sun sets, the color of sky will be red and yellow. So this picture not only describes the color of the sky, but also describes the situation of the country, because in the end of 19th century, the situation in the country wasn't good enough because of the wars, diseases. And secondly, why Edward Munch always used this kind of cheap colors, because when he began interested in painting, his father didn't approve his interest. That's why he always used cheap colors. So, secondly, Edward Munch always suffered from different kind of diseases, especially psychological diseases. That's why he always used hot colors. If you pay attention, other paintings of Edward Munch, he always used these kinds of hot colors. So this one person could describe one population who is always in a scare.
As a curator, very, very good, Sevinç, thank you very much. Full information, complicated information you gave us.
This most beautiful and famous picture, give me information please.
Okay. The painting has been traditionally considered to depict the Italian noblewoman Lisa del Giocondo. This picture, this painting's second name is called Giocondo. It's painted in oil and a white Lombardy poplar panel. Leonardo. And
Thank you. Thank you very much, ladies. That was very pleasant to listen about. Masterpiece, one of the famous masterpiece, Mona Lisa. Sitora Honu, thank you very much. Firuza, thank you very much. Solinka, are you ready? Rosa.
Yes, of course. And I want to talk about the picture, which is named The Lady of Charlotte. Mm-hmm. And this is drawn by the John William Waterhouse in 1888. And now this picture is saved in the Art Museum of Tate Britain in London. And the artist is inspired by the Alfred Lord Tennyson's lyrical ballad of...
Sorry for the... Rosa, thank you. Thank you very much. Brilliant, revealing curator. Thank you very much, Rosa. Diora and Uğurlu.
Diora, can you give me some information about this portrait? It looks very interesting.
Yes, of course. The name of this portrait is a girl with pearl earrings, and it was made in 1665 by the Jonathan Weimer. And
what do you think? What did artists want to represent by this painting?
As you can see here, the painting depicts a European girl wearing an exotic dress, and which appears as important as her earrings. And the subject of this painting is unknown, but there has been several speculations, like this woman was a real model in this period.
Wonderful! Diora, thank you very much. You are super, super curator. Thank you, ladies. So, wanted to show the classical scene of women reading a book. So more historical accuracy was not as important as the beauty of color, as the beauty of line and the beauty of shape. So look at the picture, how beautiful are the colors, yes? What colors can you see?
Pink.
Light pink. Also very interesting painting. It is made by Robert Herdman and in 1829. What can you see in the picture? Let's just name one by one. What objects are there? What who are they in the picture?
In this picture I see a queen who is then beautiful clothes.
Who is wearing beautiful clothes. Yes, you are absolutely right. She is a queen. And what's the matter with queen? Why? Where is the queen? Is this a palace?
No.
This is not a palace. This is execution place. So execute the axe, yes, the axe. And but the queen, innocent queen, cannot see it, and he is going forward proudly because she was innocent. So this is the story of the innocent Queen Mary. She is this execution was according to the order of Elizabeth the Queen. Elizabeth was her cousin.
This kind of demonstrative lesson, dear students, I liked it very much, especially your active participation during the lesson. If I'm not mistaken, the topic is itself, it's very interesting, yes? And museums, art galleries are very crucial topic. Thank you. I like the lesson.
Mm-hmm. About you, Farzona, what did you learn today?
Today's lesson is really perfect. And first of all, I learned a lot of information about art gallery and galleries, and it increases our imagination, of course.
Yes, that's all. You are absolutely right. It can improve your outlook. Thank you, Farzona, for being active in my lesson. You are perfect, my dear. So, Mohamed.
Museums, for example, Louvre and other museums. I learned.
Ola, did you learn something today?
Yes, of course. I can tell you with sure that today's lesson was very productive for me, and because I have learned a lot of advanced vocabularies.
The lesson is over. You are welcome. Goodbye.
Bye. Bye.